Right. But the point is, it's very, very important to maintain personal relations and personal connections with the people who follow you. Because they follow you for a reason. They want some value out of you. They want that connect with me. And that's what I want to stand for. Right. Sure. I try to reply to as many DMs as possible. A lot of people, when I send them replies, here's a classic reply I get back from them. And they say, oh my God, you replied.
That's how underrated
it is, because I just want to know their mindset. Ki agar main reply, agar main kisi ko kuch DM kar raha hun, aren't they expecting a reply?
Yeah.
What are they expecting? I mean, do they expect that I won't reply? Do they expect that I'll just see and leave it on scene? What do they expect? So if I see that there's a sensible DM, genuine, coming from a genuine place, I tend to reply to as many as I can.
Hey listeners, welcome to this episode of Mango Talk, where we talk to your favorite creators, artists, and influencers and share with you their journey, their life, the technical aspects of their life as well, which can help you possibly become better creators and where you can draw inspiration from. Today, we have an entrepreneur, come a content creator with us, Deepak, whose content I've been following since we belong to the same city and Calcutta is a small place. I've been following his content for a long time and I have seen him growing personally this year. And I'm sure I'll let him talk about this entire thing, because his case study, what I feel, is something which is insane and something which all of us can actually get a lot of valuable insights from. On that note, hi Deepak, how are you doing today? What's up?
That's a great introduction, Ishmeet. Thank you so much for having me. It feels good to be here. I know you're from the same city. We've interacted before, I guess, at a cafe or somewhere in Calcutta, but not in person and not very detailed manner. So, good to connect with you here, and good to speak to you. How's it going? What's happening?
It's all good, man. It's all good. We started this podcast, pretty excited about it. And I asked Divyanshu, like, speak to Deepak, man. I really want to talk to him. I know you guys are pretty tight and I think we can get some massive inputs out of that. So I just want you to introduce yourself to the audience as well. And, you know, give them a brief introduction of who you are in case they don't know it. Right? Over to you.
Lovely. Lovely. So, hey guys, to everybody who's listening to this podcast, my name is Deepak Parthik. I come from Calcutta, the city of joy. I've done my schooling from Don Bosco School, Park Circus. I've done my college from St. Xavier's, Calcutta. Primarily as to who I am. So I'm an entrepreneur. I'm the co-founder at an edtech startup called Career Kira. We're launching a selfish plugin. We'll be launching our app very soon in the next 10 days. So stay tuned for that. So I'm the co-founder at Career Kira. We basically talk about practical training and skill development courses, which is profession specific. So say, for example, if you're a CA or a CS or a BCom or an LLB, we basically give you the practical training in terms of a specific profession so that you understand that profession in out center from the practical aspect of things. So, and plus you stand out among your peers in terms of employability because you have the practical training regarding that particular profession. So that's what we aim at doing. So that way, I am an entrepreneur. I'm the co-founder at Career Kira. Secondly, I am a content creator. I've been creating content for the past two and a half years. This August, I'll be completing 3 years of my content creation journey. And that's what I've been up to. And I'm passionate about cricket, to be really honest. I've played cricket for Bengal before. But of course, now things are not as it seems. So that's taken a drop, but still very enthusiastic about cricket, still very enthusiastic, passionate about, even if it's a match or a post-match presentation, you can, hit me up and we can have a long, long, detailed discussion.
Great. I think the squads are out for tomorrow's test match. I'm sure all of us are looking forward to it. Yeah, I'm sure you are.
Lovely. Yeah. I am looking forward to it. To be really honest,
Should be good. So you mentioned at length about Career Kira and, about it being in the edtech space. Now, that's a very interesting place to be in. And also, we are in New Year. 2020 was a year where I think a lot of edtech startups also got funded, got a lot of money, put in a lot of money because people wanted to do courses online. So How has that worked in your favor? Have you tried to capitalize on it? And how has it worked out overall? What's the goal?
Okay, so I think we are till now a bootstrap startup, and we have we've been very fortunate, and we take full pride in being a bootstrap startup. Yeah. I think when we talk about some myths about entrepreneurship, this is one of the biggest myths about entrepreneurship, that you need to raise funds to become a successful startup. Whereas people do not understand the simplest of the simple meanings of the term bootstrap. So I think we take immense pride in saying that we are a bootstrap startup. And I think it has worked in our favor. We were about to launch the app that goes live now in 10 days. We were about to launch that last year. Okay. And so because of that, I think we were supposed to do some kind of testings in the market, basically launching the MVP in the market. But I think all of those costs related to the launch and all these things have been negated because it's already been tested. We were supposed to test it out, saying that, okay, will online work? Will online not work? Will people be able to learn sitting at the comfort of their homes? Will that be accepted? Thanks to the pandemic, it has automatically been accepted.
Nice.
So, sara kharcha nikal gaya, sab kuch sab khatam ho gaya, and it's already been tested. So, right now, finally, we are launching in 10 days, maybe 10-15 days. We're launching the first course on the platform. It's the course is called SPC, Secretarial Practices Course. And it's meant for CACS students, Chartered Accountants and Company Secretary students. Whereas we basically provide them the basic practical training that's required so that they can get equipped with the industry. And it will help them in employability. Because, you know, we understand both of us come from the same city, Calcutta.
Yeah.
And the combination of BCom plus CA seems to be the hot combination for every commerce student out here.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
So I think that's something that we need to tap on. The longer vision is to create employability in this sector, whereas so that we become more and more skillful, we become more and more employable in the 21st century by imparting the right skills. Yeah. I think degree is given a lot of importance. I mean, till last year or till probably 3 to 4 years back, getting a degree was considered a very, very, very important. But right now, I think thanks to the pandemic, we're moving towards a gig economy, whereas skills will be preferred over degrees. Contractual work will be more and more emphasized on. So I think we basically focus on creating more and more employability and creating more and more, creating people who are more and more skillful.
Nice. Yeah, that's a great vision. And it's in line with what's happening in the current world scenario as well. So I'm sure, and I hope for sure that it works out in your favor. All the best for that, man. Cheers.
All right. Thanks, man. Cheers.
Let's, Deepak, come to more of the content creation side of things from your end. All right. So like I said, I've been personally following you for a very long time. And your content before the reels hit the market was primarily interviewing these people. I think you've spoken to quite a few big creators as well. Abhi and Niu, Viraj Ghilani. I saw their posts. I've seen the content as well. And then when reels hit, your profile is flooded with tons and tons and tons of reels. Right. So I want to ask you here, what was the process of your content creation pre-reels and what is the process now as such?
Love this. Thank you so much for this question. I genuinely wanted to answer this question for a very long time now. So I think pre-reel, if you speak to Divyanshu has been a very good friend of mine.
Yeah.
We are from the same school, same college, same batch. So I've known him practically for over 18, 20 years now.
Right.
So I think if you ask him about how I was as a school student, how I was as a college student, he'll be better able to describe me as a person because he practically has seen me from school. Right. From the very nascent stages of me as a student. Mm-hmm. And I was the most introverted kid back in school. Right, I used to never raise my hand while answering a question. So I'm sure Divyanshu must have spoken to the team about, you know, very simple things like raising your hands and asking questions.
Right.
Or maybe just raising your hand and answering a particular question. So I think it was very simple. I was never that extroverted or I was never that confident to, you know, raise my hand and answer a question, all of those things. But as content creation started, as I took upon this journey, I think life completely, completely changed and for good. It's a no-brainer that it's changed for good. So I think pre-reel, the strategy or probably my way of creating content was ki mereko content banana tha, mereko realistic content banana tha. I had a particular niche, but I had a lot of queries in mind. Ki yaar, kaisa type ka content chalega, whether a particular niche whether it's actually required to create content or not, whether video content works better, whether carousel posts work better, whether just image posts work better, whether going live works better. I was just figuring out.
Right.
And my initial niche when I started back in 2018, August of 2018, my initial niche was Mythbusters. So I wanted to create myth-busting, thought-provoking content.
Right.
But eventually I realized that a lot of people came up to me and told me, Deepak, what are you doing different? Anybody can research, look it up on the internet and talk about these myths. So what are you doing different? Well, of course, you need to ignore these people. But to a certain extent, I thought that, okay, they might be correct. What am I doing different? So I eventually, tried to make a shift very slowly and gradually. And when the pandemic hit, I thought, of course, every creator mostly resorted to going live on Instagram. I thought, chalo, ye bhi kar lete, let's try this. And there was no plan as such. Mere paas koi plan nahi tha ki main isko bulaunga, I'll call him or I'll call her. Let's just interact with them. Theme kya aane wala tha, kuch bhi decided nahi tha. But eventually, mere ko laga ki iska ek naam dena chahiye. So I named it Getting Candid.
Yes.
Right? And that's where the journey began. So I reached out to more and more people. I reached out to a lot of people. I cold emailed them. I sent them DMs. I mentioned them on Twitter handles. All of those things I've done. And that's where I've realized one thing, which is you have to take that first step from yourself and reach out to people. Do not assume that just because he or she has a blue tick or he or she has a mass following, they won't reply or they won't get back to you. Yeah. Do not assume that. What you can do is reach out to them with a win-win collaboration. Tell them why you need them. Tell them that, okay, this is something that I'm planning to do and you seem to be the best person for it. So let's just take out 30 minutes or 45 minutes of your time and let's just talk about it. More than, 9 out of 10 times they will agree to it. They will agree with it.
All right.
So I think all of those, so Instagram live happened. I think I've spoken to 40 odd people, more than 40 odd people. From creators to actors to influencers to celebrities to a lot of people. Right. And that's where I've learned a lot of things. Right. Right now I don't have a team for my content creation journey. I do this all by myself. Right. And that's not a lot of people know about this.
Okay. Right?
I have a team with respect to my startup.
Right.
Of course, brainstorming happens with them.
Mm-hmm.
Start to both my startup as well as my content. But I do not have a specific team for my content. Not a lot of people know about this. I'm glad I'm talking about this openly right now because this is something that I'm doing all by myself.
Yes.
The content brainstorming, I initiate the conversations. I discuss it with my partner, Mohit. He comes back to me, says, ki mat karo, ye mat karo, phir ye kar lo. Great, fantastic. I go ahead and do it. So coming back to your original question, just pre-reels and post-reels, how life has changed and how I take content as, I think it's pretty interesting because till pre-reel, I was figuring out kya karna chahiye and all of that. Now, since I've made that shift, also, fun fact, my reels started with memes. If you scroll back to my reels section, if you watch the first 10, 12 odd videos, I actually wanted to make funny content on reels. So I wanted to try out that as well.
Right.
Because I remember I put up this story saying that I really want to try out reels. Because reels is becoming more like TikTok, where there's a lot of cringe content. I don't want to get into cringe content. I want to do something for which I stand for. So let's just try funny content because we all want to laugh. If we see something funny, we make a laugh out of it, right?
Yeah.
So I thought ki ye bhi try karte, dekhte kaisa jata hai. And people started loving it. From there, I got the initial traction. So if you go to my reels section, if you go to my initial first 10, 12 videos, you'll find that I tried funny content as well. And then I started making shift one by one. Ek-ek karke, I kept on going by the flow. And I realized this one thing. If you stay consistent and if you stay true to your work, you got it, bro. You absolutely got it. I think this is one thing that people don't understand with regard to content. You have to stay consistent.
Right.
I think consistency is the key. Yeah, go ahead.
No, that you mentioned about, I have also seen this another video of yours where you spoke, I think you've spoken multiple times about being consistent, and people think, yeah, ye to sab bolte, but the problem is sab ye nahi kar rahe hai. So even if you're doing something as basic as being consistent, you will eventually see your numbers growing. And more importantly, your numbers, your content will reach out to more and more people deeply. And I think that should be the goal for sure. Great, man. I think that that's
absolutely. I think, just to add to that, I think it's really important as to, so a lot of people also ask me, Deepak, what niche do you cater to? And at times I find this funny because, you know, I'm always sharing my experiences. I'm always sharing my story, something that I have gone through. So if you talk, this is exactly what Gary Vee also says.
Right.
People will follow you for who you are. Right? Not when you put up a facade and, you know, talk about something that you actually don't have any idea about. People will follow you for who you are. You share your experiences, you document your journey. People will love you for that.
You have to
be your authentic self. Like that goes without saying, bro. Yeah.
Super underrated, but actually very able. Be yourself and
super underrated. Yeah.
People won't follow you if the person you're pretending to be. Maybe one month, 2 months ho jayega, but then you're gonna see a drop. Because that's not who you're portraying. Okay, so since you mentioned about the TikTok thing as well, that Reels is slowly becoming to TikTok. Did you ever try creating content on TikTok before Reels hit the market? Like, this is not something I'm aware of because I wasn't an avid TikTok user. So did you?
I was not a TikTok user, but I eventually, I came on TikTok. I created my ID. I started creating more videos. I mean, not many videos. There were like 4 or 5 videos.
Okay.
And eventually it got banned. So not much to talk about TikTok, but honestly speaking, I think, when there was buzz about TikTok, I think the only thing that we were aware of is there's just cringe content.
Cringe content, yeah.
There's not much
valuable
activity or not much valuable insight. Yes. I mean, it's not just about value. I mean, it's not that zaruri nahi ki aapko sirf value in terms of information provide karna. Aapko zaruri nahi hai in terms of music provide karna. It could be anything. But agar pure platform mein cringe content bhara hua hai, if everybody is interested in spitting water out of their mouth and playing it in slow-mo, I think that's where the platform loses its authenticity.
Yes, I think that's somewhere Reels has been very smart. They've always positioned themselves as a creative expression for people. Even the ads which come on TV, they talk about creative expression. That's beautiful, what I feel. Great.
And you must have noticed that not many features are, I mean, jab pehle koi feature nikla tha for Instagram, say IGTV or say whichever feature, they were not spending enough on TV ads. They were not spending enough on TVCs. Now with regard to Reels, they're spending tons and tons of dollars on promoting Reels.
Because
they understand that they want to become a market leader in terms of,
they have to,
short form content.
Because there is so much of competition. Another thing, if you notice, certain Reels creators, like one of them, Kareema Bari, she's also from Calcutta. I remember when I saw her TV commercial of hers, I was like, whoa, I have met this person in a school fest back in class 11, 12 in Ethiopia, if you remember, I'm not sure.
I see her
on TV and creating some awesome content. It's very great and it's very inspiring as well. That's what I personally feel. Coming to I want to ask you another question here. When I was doing my research, and also I have a habit, and I spoke about this in another episode as well, with Digital Prateek, I have a habit of checking the comments on every post. I enjoy the comments. Whether it's
lovely.
I'm a big football fan, so every time there's a post, I check the comments because I value people's opinions. I don't miss the comments at all. So when I was doing that, when I saw your Reels, and even today morning when I was doing my research, before the Reels started hitting the comments, the engagement, so to speak, was not that much, right? And now there are so many comments on every Reel, right? So when this engagement shift happened, I'm sure you started getting a lot of queries, a lot of comments, a lot of DMs. How vital it is to interact with it and be consistent even there? Something I really want to know.
So I'm glad you put this up because the major reason why you will stand out as a creator is when you, so I take this classic example of Ankush Bahuguna, right? So what does Ankush do? Ankush, whenever you see his story, he's at his raw best, right? He's at his raw best. Even if he has this very funny tagline. Okay, he says, "ये तो मेरी strategy है, मैं करूँगा." Right? So why does he say that? I mean, he says what he has to say, and then converts that into a joke, and then puts it up. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. So I think it's very important as to how you interact with the audience. I think I was speaking to Divyanshu as well, where I was thinking about content with him. And he said focus, we were discussing about focus on the depth and not the width. And then I happened to create a reel on that. So it genuinely matters as to, it doesn't matter whether you have 500 followers or 500K followers, right? What matters is whether you're following, the number of following that you have, whether you have a deeper connection among your followers, right? Whether you have a deeper connection or not. And that's what I try to build. Whether I get a nonsensical DM, of course, I know which DMs to reply to and which DMs to not reply to. Mm-hmm. Of course, there are nonsensical DMs. I ignore, block, restrict, whatever DM that deserves. Right. But when there's a genuine question where people are asking me questions or when people are appreciating my talent or when people are coming up with feedback saying, Deepak, this is something that I'd like you to improve on. Right. I genuinely appreciate that, because if somebody takes out 5 minutes, 10 minutes of their time and tells me that, Deepak, I would love to see this that you improve on this, and I would love to see a new video where we see this implemented. Fantastic. I love this. Yeah, okay. So sure. I think it started with reels where the engagement jab aane lag gaya. I was getting some comments. Dheere comments bharte gaya, and then eventually people started relating and resonating with my content. So eventually, and I give full credit, because usually hota kya hai, when you start creating content, replying to each and every comment is very underrated. That's not true, bro. You have to engage as much as you can. Right? So in my initial comments, of course, when you see that I've replied to every comment. हर कमेंट के नीचे मेरा कुछ ना कुछ रिप्लाई होगा ही होगा. टिल द टाइम इट्स पॉसिबल फॉर मी टू डू सो, राइट? जहां आफ्टर सर्टेन पॉइंट टाइम होता नहीं, जरूरी नहीं है कि आपको इतना टाइम मिले कि आप हर कमेंट के नीचे रिप्लाई करो. यू माइट हैव 200 कमेंट्स, इट्स इम्पॉसिबल फॉर यू टू रिप्लाई टू ऑल द 200 कमेंट्स, राइट? हो जाते हैं, बहुत कमेंट्स मिस हो जाते हैं यार, इट्स बट ऑब्वियस, राइट? बट द पॉइंट इज, इट्स वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू मेंटेन पर्सनल रिलेशंस एंड पर्सनल कनेक्शंस with the people who follow you, because they follow you for a reason. They want some value out of you. They want that connect with me. And that's what I want to stand for. Right? Sure. I try to reply to as many DMs as possible. A lot of people, when I send them replies, here's a classic reply I get back from them. And they say, oh my God, you replied. That's how underrated it is, because I just want to know their mindset. If I reply, if I DM someone, aren't they expecting a reply?
Yeah.
What are they expecting? I mean, do they expect that I won't reply? Do they expect that I'll just see and leave it on scene? What do they expect? So, if I see that there's a sensible DM, genuine, coming from a genuine place, I tend to reply to as many as I can.
Think of it, what you just mentioned, like, this actually piqued my mind as well. They send a DM with the expectation that obviously banda respond karega, but if he's not,
exactly,
the entire ethos of a message is going to waste. So
exactly,
for everybody who's listening to this, it's super important, and it's the most basic thing. Yeah, but you don't have to give a chora explanation like this. Aram se, even if you send a hey or acha, what can I help you with, they will remember you. I am sure.
Exactly.
They remember.
And
that's what,
now and now is the depth. So bahut sare, sorry to cut you there, but bahut sare questions aise aate hain na jahan pe queries hote hain,
right?
Because I am working in an industry which is related to education, because I talk a lot about which relates to skills and education and,
right,
you know, how you can upskill yourself and all of those things. People ask me questions about career related stuff, about how we can upskill ourselves, about what skills are required in the future, or how can we get internships and all of those things. So if there's a broader answer to it, I send them DMs. I send them voice notes. I don't type it out, because it's impossible for you to type such a long answer. Right? So just press on that voice, that mic, and just record your raw version and send it to them.
they will be I think super like very crucial yaar, it's such a nice, they will be like are baap
अरे क्या हो यार दीपक कैसे रिप्लाई कर दिया that exactly how what I hear. So I think it's super underrated but goes a long way in establishing that connect with the audience.
Right, Deepak, moving on, there's this one particular video which you made which was very interesting and I've not seen any creator doing it. It's where you spoke about the phases of a creator or an influencer, right? So you start full josh se ki yaar main to best content creator, you get an initial traction, brand collaboration, then there's a dip. And actually, I would like to talk about it first, give people a perspective and you give your own experience with it in a way. And what kind of a response did you get? Because I saw the comments, people were like, "Arey, bap, bap. We didn't think of it this way, yet this is so true." So I would like you to talk about it and give people a, you know, talk about it as well.
I'm glad you bring this up because usually what, so if you follow my content very closely, I do not try to put forward something that's not the truth.
Right.
So in short, I do not try to say something where I'm sugarcoating facts.
Got it. Yeah.
Right? So I just try to put out the truth, even if it's harsh, even if it's something that's super harsh, chubega. Super rude to hear.
Yeah.
Chubega. Wo dil pe chubna chahiye, boss. Tabhi baat nikalti hai. Tabhi wo, tabhi lagna chahiye na, bro.
Got it.
So if somebody comes up to me and tells me ki are bro one of your close friends, theek hai chalo random changes on internet ka baat chodo, close friend comes up to you and tells you, yaar Ishmeet, I didn't expect this from you bro, main dil tod diya tumhara baat, tumko chubega ki nahi chubega, you'll feel like are yaar I let him down or I let her down, I shouldn't have done that. Right? So that's exactly what I want to do. I want to put out the truth wherein I just say what I feel. So which is what I've learned as a creator. When I made this series where I talked about my failures as an entrepreneur, what I learned as being an entrepreneur.
Yeah.
There was a 6-part series on my reels where I talked about failures as an entrepreneur, or 6 or 9 things I learned as a creator, or 6 things you should do if you're a college student, right? So ye sab series se mereko ye samajh mein aaya that just put out, just be your authentic self and put the truth out.
Yeah.
People will fall in love with it because people relate with the truth. People relate with what it is, right? So When I put out that reel about that graph wherein you start with full high energy, full josh, like, "Arey, ab to create karenge, ab to million views do din mein le aayenge," hai na? And then you fall back because there are no views. You just started. There are no views, low views, no likes, no comments, no DMs. Okay. And then you're on an all time high when there are brand deals. Come back again low because you're not feel like doing anything. I mean, you're not feeling good. You're again at your top when you feel good on that particular day, you come back down again when there are moments of self doubt, right? So that was the entire reel.
Yeah,
you come again because you feel that arey yaar is industry mein mere ko growth nahi mil raha, I doubt myself, am I creative enough, am I not creative enough, what exactly is the scene? So I think again that comes from a place of truth where I actually wanted to put the truth out there, where I actually wanted to tell them that this is exactly the life of a creator or an influencer or an artist who's putting content out there,
right?
And it's true. I mean, that's what people go through. Today I might feel I might be at my creative best. Tomorrow I might miserably fail at it, right? So that's what people don't get. And a lot of people ask me, Deepak, how are you so consistent?
Right?
How are you so consistent? How do you get ideas? How do you get so many ideas? Itna sara ideas har din kaise aata hai? Right? And I made a video on this as well, where I talked about how I get my ideas for my content. And it is just simple incidents that happen with me throughout the entire day. So say, for example, what my creation process is. Say, for example, I get up at 10 o'clock in the morning. Okay? Just an example. I don't get up at 10 o'clock, but just an example.
Sure.
Say you get up at 10 o'clock in the morning. Okay? An incident happens with you. Say, जैसे ही आप रूम से बाहर निकल के हॉल में गए, पापा ने आपको डांट दिया, फॉर एग्जाम्पल. यू कैन इधर रिएक्ट इन अ, आई मीन, व्हाट कैन यू डू, यू कैन लिसन टू दैट स्कोल्डिंग, कह रहे यार मेरे को डांट क्यों पड़ी, और यू कैन से कि पापा मेरी गलती नहीं थी, आप क्यों डांट रहे हो, समथिंग ऑफ दैट. सो सिंपल इंसिडेंट को कैन यू कन्वर्ट दैट इंटू अ कॉन्टेंट पीस, कैन यू कन्वर्ट दैट इंटू अ पीस ऑफ कॉन्टेंट. एंड हाउ डू आई रिमेंबर ऑल ऑफ दीज थिंग्स, आई हैव अ व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप in which I am the only member.
Yeah.
Okay. So whenever I come across a particular incident or a particular line or a particular quote which I feel can be converted into a potential content piece, bilkul notes bana lo, and before you end the day, before you call it a day, before you go to sleep, refine karo wo sab sare ke sare content pieces ko. वो एक रॉ आइडिया से स्टार्ट होता है कि यार मेरे को पता है कि हाँ ये रॉ आइडिया है, अब इसको और रिफाइन करना है. रिफाइन करने के बाद यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड कि यार इसको रिलेटेबल कैसे बनाया जाए.
अच्छा,
बिकॉज फॉर मी, फॉर माय इंस्टाग्राम, आई डू नॉट हैव 30 सेकंड्स का ऑप्शन.
अच्छा,
आर यू देयर?
या आई एम देयर, आई एम देयर.
या या, ओके, कैन यू हियर मी? यू कैन हियर मी, राइट? या, सो फॉर माय इंस्टाग्राम आई स्टिल डोंट हैव 30 सेकंड्स का ऑप्शन. I still have 15 seconds option. So I have to restrict myself to 15 seconds only.
Why is that?
Okay. So I have to, I don't know. I mean, okay. It's just that a lot of creator accounts still haven't got the 30 seconds option.
Right.
So you, a lot of people assume ki yaar sirf 15 second ka content kyun bana raha hai. I don't have 30 seconds option. There are people who are telling me, can you please update the app? What makes you think I haven't tried that option? So I think I've done all that can be done,
right,
but it's
right.
Just that I haven't received it. But whatever, jo bhi hai. But so main sone ke pehle I refine every piece of content. Theek hai? Check whether that is relatable to others or not. Theek hai? And then usage of the correct words. Which will put out the exact message that I intend to put out. बिकॉज मेरे पास 15 सेकंड है. मेरे पास 15 सेकंड है. आई हैव 15 सेकंड्स टू क्रिएट एन इम्पैक्ट. कैन आई मेक एन इम्पैक्ट इन 15 सेकंड? सो दैट्स एग्जैक्टली दिस इज इन टर्म्स ऑफ रील्स. ऑफ कोर्स व्हिचएवर टॉपिक दैट रिक्वायर्स अ डिटेल्ड एक्सप्लेनेशन आई टेंड टू क्रिएट मोर एंड मोर लॉन्गर फॉर्मेट वीडियोस, व्हिच ऑफ कोर्स गोज ऑन माय यूट्यूब एज वेल, गोज ऑन माय Instagram as well. Shorter pieces, maybe two liners, goes out as tweets. I think that's basically the a fair bit of my content creation process.
Tell you something, Deepak. When you mentioned about the groups, that is something I truly believe in. I myself keep three groups. Ek mein this, ek mein reminders, and ek mein just any photos or videos that I need to transfer from my phone to the desktop. I make sure, and it's very helpful.
Yeah.
It's very helpful. That's the first thing which you see. Yeah. All right, cool, man. I think we've covered quite a bit here. And actually, another thing I wanted to ask you, there was a specific video where you
were
with Abhi and Niu, right? And you mentioned that once they hit that top, you know, like, oh my God, this one piece of content got viral. I think they had, I don't know how many crore views. And then they were the one in China, and then they were like,
pressure after 1 crore views.
Yeah, that was the video. And then what recently happened when Yashraj Mukhate, I'm sure you know.
Of course,
everybody knows him. So what happened was, he recently put out a commercial during IPL. He made a song on Dream 11. All right. I watched again. I saw the comments. Then I just saw a few articles and people were like, ye utna bhi achha nahi hai, iska standard gir raha hai. Kya wo wala purana likhe ho. And then now he's come up with another banger, that Tommy wala. All right.
It can
get so difficult. I mean, I know right now we were talking about start kaise karna hai, consistent kaise rehna hai. But once you're there, even maintaining that level is difficult, right? So if you could give people, you know, a perspective, aisa situation mein kya karo, I think from whatever kind of interactions you've had and maybe even you've experienced personally, what should be the way out, and more importantly, the way forward?
Okay, so I remember, just because you mentioned this, I remember this one tweet that I had read somewhere, wherein that person was saying that, of course, you all know the Kardashians family, right?
Yeah.
So that person was talking about, we all know that Kardashian family is super viral. Every post there hits a million views, hits a million likes, all of those things,
right?
And a lot of people say they got it very easy, right? Now, getting something easy is one thing, but maintaining or sustaining that consistency is another thing. Maintaining or sustaining that virality is taking your content game to another level, right? So that is what I believe in. I feel jahan pe, so when I was doing this live with Abhi and you, I was, if I correctly remember, I was at 1800 followers, okay, 1.8k followers,
okay,
and 1.8k bhi nahi tha, I think 1.7k or 1.6k aisa kuch tha,
okay,
theek hai, and वो लाइफ जब खत्म हुआ बिकॉज अभी नहीं हो देवर दैट टाइम देवर एट 600K ठीक है, सो दैट टाइम कोर्स लेवरेज थोड़ा सा मेरे को मिल गया फ्रॉम अभी लॉट ऑफ देयर फॉलोअर्स फिगर आउट कि हाँ दीपक भी कोई क्रिएटर है लेट्स लेट्स सी हिम लेट्स चेक हिम आउट ऑन ऑल दोस थिंग्स सो आई रीच्ड एट 1.8K और समथिंग आई गॉट लेवरेज फ्रॉम अभी एंड न्यू एज वेल राइट बट और उसके बाद मेरे पास इंस्टेंट थॉट आया कि यार मेरे पास बहुत प्रेशर हो गया क्योंकि 200 लोग नए आ गए अब 200 लोग को मेरा कॉन्टेंट पसंद आएगा कि नहीं आएगा I'm at 1.8K from 1.6K. अब वो प्रेशर कितना बड़ा प्रेशर है मेरे लिए बिकॉज मेरे को लग रहा है कि यार अब मैं 2000 टच करने वाला हूँ 2000 लोग मेरे को फॉलो करते हैं यार तो मैं ऐसा क्या बना रहा हूँ कि या तो मैं बहुत ही अच्छा बना रहा हूँ ताकि मेरे को 2000 लोग मेरे को फॉलो कर रहे हैं यार आई हैवंट सीन 2000 पीपल लाइव आई मीन एक जगह पे इमेजिन इफ यू मीट ऑल योर फॉलोअर्स एट वन प्लेस This is the number of people who follow you. It blows your mind.
Hmm.
Right? So उस समय वो प्रेशर था कि अरे यार अभी मैं 2K टच करने वाला
हूँ
2000 लोग मेरे को फॉलो कर दे यार there has to be some content strategy.
Hmm.
Right? Now when I've got some following, now I feel कि अरे यार मतलब क्या हो रहा है भाई कैसे इसको maintain किया जाए कैसे इसको like I had this thought before also कि यार व्हाट इफ पीपल डोंट लाइक माय कंटेंट जो नए नए फॉलो कर रहे हैं आफ्टर अ सर्टेन पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम क्या पता उनको मेरा कंटेंट पसंद नहीं आए बट ओवर टाइम आई हैव रियलाइज्ड दिस वन थिंग कि यार पीपल विल फॉलो यू फॉर हु यू आर अगर आप अपना कंटेंट बदल दोगे या फिर ट्वीक अराउंड कर दोगे जस्ट बिकॉज दे डोंट लाइक इट शॉर्ट टर्म में बहुत से लोगों को पसंद आ जाए बट लॉन्ग टर्म में इट विल हार्म योर ब्रांड राइट तो वो चीज बहुत डिफिकल्ट है अदरवाइज क्योंकि क्या होता है जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई शेयर इज बेसिकली thought-provoking content.
Hmm.
Of course, stuff here and there related to cricket because I'm a huge cricket aficionado. So I share stuff around here and there around cricket.
Hmm.
And jo bhi agar thoda bahut bhi funny lag gaya, thoda bahut I try to you know maybe put something sarcastic or something witty, which I feel that I can put out.
Right.
So I think that's where people fall in love with. And I realize that logo ko ye pasand aa raha hai. Because main kuch change nahi kar raha hoon. This is who I am as a person.
Yeah, different version, like not even different version, just exploring more parts of yourself and putting it out there.
Again, exactly. So this is who I am.
Yeah.
I mean, I love cricket. I love to talk about cricket.
Why not?
If you don't like it, I mean, you cannot have cannot have all the pieces of the cake.
Right. Nice.
Right. You have to share it with people. So I think it's really really important ki aap. इस पे ज्यादा प्रेशर मत लो एज अ क्रिएटर इफ यू फील दैट यू हैव अ सर्टेन अमाउंट ऑफ फॉलोइंग इवन इफ इट्स 500 फॉलोअर्स और इवन इफ इट्स 500K डू नॉट टेक अ लॉट ऑफ प्रेशर ऑन योरसेल्फ कि यार मेरे पास इतना इतना फॉलोइंग है तो मेरे को अब बहुत प्रेशर है कि क्या कॉन्टेंट क्रिएट करो आप वेन यू हैव अ सर्टेन फॉलोइंग यू कैन डायरेक्टली आस्क पीपल पुट अप अ क्वेश्चन स्टिकर एंड आस्क देम व्हाट वुड दे लाइक टू सी एंड जस्ट आस्क देम कि यार क्या व्हाट वुड दे लाइक टू सी इट्स एज सिंपल एंड देन Be at your authentic self. I think ye authenticity wala cheez can never go out of fashion.
Got it. Nice. Very nice. And a very true answer. And laga, I think log ye simple facets bhi follow karenge, they will see themselves growing heaps and bounds. Right? On that note,
absolutely. Deepak,
we've covered so much. I think we've gotten lots of insights and people are going to hear this conversation, are going to love it. I hope for the same. So you've come to the last part of this podcast where I'm going to ask you quick fire questions. In the last podcast, somebody told me, "Bhai, rapid fire, mat bol, main intimidate ho jata." Cool, quick fire. It's not a one-word answer. You can take your time. Just short, sweet, beautiful answers. Just so that people know who you are and at the same time, acha, man, that was an interesting answer. All right,
cool. Hello, done.
So we'll go with that first. All right, five or six questions. I'll start with the first one. All set? Are you ready?
Yeah. Great, pressure great, create mat karo one is ready. ready you.
nice. Yeah, cool. First one. Okay. Collaborate, keep on hold, say no. Who would you do for the same? Yashraj Mukhate, Gaurav Taneja, or Carrie Minati?
Wow.
Yeah.
Collaborate. Who else?
Collaborate, keep on hold or stall rather and say no to. Yashraj Mukhate, Gaurav Taneja, or Carrie
keep
Minati.
On hold and say no. Oh my God. This is
bouncer.
This is a bouncer. Actually, I don't know whether to duck or to pull it off. I mean, it's...
You have to pull it off. I don't have an option.
Okay. Say no to Carrie Minati, because I mean, do I have to give a reason for it?
I would love to hear that.
I mean, there's no specific reason. I have to say no to somebody.
So, yeah, okay, go on. Okay, Cariminati.
So, Cariminati, no.
Got it.
Hold and collaborate. That's a good one. That's a good one. Okay, collaborate with Yashraj and hold for Ulta.
Okay.
Collaborate with Gaurav Taneja and keep on hold for Yashraj Mukhate. Reason being, Yashraj Mukhate ko main hold nahi karna chahunga. I would love to take him on.
Yeah.
But because I want to focus on long form content also now for my YouTube, I think
nobody
Gaurav Taneja is the man.
The king. Yeah. Nice.
I mean striking a million views in his last 120-30 videos is not a joke. It's beautiful. The way that man is creating content on YouTube every single day and clocking a million views for his last 120-130 videos is not a joke.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
His recent gaming channel hit 500K.
Yes.
Hit a million subscribers in 4 days.
That's the power of the
what are you talking about?
Because again, authenticity, true to yourself, and it's a connectable content. I personally enjoy it as well.
Absolutely. Matlab, it's unheard of for an Indian creator, individual creator, that too. So, of course, I mean, collaborate with, Yashraj would be a dream because he's the viral sensation now.
Yes.
But collaborate with Gaurav Taneja. Okay.
Smart answer. Pulled it off. Yeah. Nice one. All right, next. A personality trait that you look for in people which you believe will help you connect with them much better.
Patience. No brainer. Because I am very impatient. Okay. And I'm working on it. Okay. I'm slowly and gradually working on it. मेरे को लगता है कि यार बहुत जल्दबाजी में कुछ बोल देता हूँ फिर मेरे को लगता है कि अरे यार शिट ये नहीं बोलना चाहिए था.
Got it.
ठीक है तो patience is something that I look for in a lot of people. And one more quality, one more trait, which is curiosity. I want people to be randomly curious. Like only yesterday this happened where I was sitting at my office, sitting with my team. And there was this one girl who walked up to me and said, "Ki Deepak, I'd like to know about a few things. So can you please explain ki ye kya hota hai?" Theek hai? When I explained that, she said, "Iske baare mein bhi mereko janna hai. Acha, iske baare mein bhi mereko janna hai." So there were a lot of follow-up questions, which mereko laga ki yaar, this is very, because ye random curiosity bahut khatam hote ja raha hai. So I think curiosity and
very nice, very nice. It's a good way to connect to people for sure. All right, next. If you had access to a time machine, where and when would you go?
इसका आंसर देना जरूरी है ना. got to think about it, but I think I would love to not go in the future because that's something that I would love to experience it myself and not be ahead of.
Nice.
So I would love to go maybe 20 years back or maybe like जितना बड़ा मैं जितना maturity level मेरी अभी है वो same maturity level रहे 20 years पहले. Like probably the time that I was born. So for example, I was born in 96. So 96 mein is level ki maturity ho. That would be like, bro, kya chal kya raha hai?
Yeah, sahi hai. So
I think that would be something that would be lovely to see.
Nice, nice. All right. One thing, and this is the last question. One thing you would like to change from your daily routine?
One thing that I'd like to change from my daily routine. Work out more. that's something that I'd like to change. I do not work out every single day. So that I'd love to change that. Apart from that, I think it's just. I mean, I'm getting into a routine. I mean, a lot of people feel that being disciplined is uncool, but discipline is the new cool.
Yes.
Like it goes without saying, but discipline is the new cool. So. Something that I really, really focus on. Even if I'm not working out, I try to play badminton for an hour or so every single day,
nice.
Which keeps me going, you know, the entire day and my day on a high. But I think one thing that I'd like to change is work out probably every single day,
nice.
which is something that I'd like to incorporate in my routine.
I think that's something which everybody wants, including myself. Let's hope it all works out for all of us. All right, Deepak, yeah. I think personally, this was awesome. I've gotten some incredible insights and I'm glad we could have this conversation. On an ending note, I'd like to say, I would want love for you to say something to the listeners. Go on. Yeah.
Okay. So to everybody who is listening to this podcast, I think just simple advice to, I'm sure the audience is pretty young. And I'm sure the audience is pretty, maybe if you're in college or maybe if you've just graduated or whoever the audience who's listening to it, do not put a cap on your capacity to impact people.
Nice.
Please never, never, never underestimate yourself. Because if I can come this far, this is what I say, and I have major imposter syndrome. Okay, so I feel ki arre yaar, यार कि यार ये मेरे साथ नहीं हो सकता, दिस इज समथिंग दैट ये इतना मेहनत तो मैंने करी नहीं जितना हो गया. बट आई थिंक अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल अंडरएस्टिमेट देयर टैलेंट, अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल अंडरएस्टिमेट एज टू हु दे आर. एंड प्लीज डू नॉट अंडरएस्टिमेट योरसेल्फ. एंड देयर इज अ बिग डिबेट आउट देयर अबाउट टू थिंग्स. वन इज कि अगर आप छोटे हो तो आप ज्यादा बहुत बड़ा चीज नहीं कर सकते विद रिगार्ड टू एज. एंड सेकंड इज कि पैशन को लेकर बहुत बड़ा डाउट है कि पैशन फॉलो करना है. सो व्हाट, हाउ डू वी फॉलो पैशन, आवर पैशन. ठीक है, सिंपल चीज है, प्लीज नेवर लेट गो ऑफ योर पैशन. प्लीज नेवर लेट गो ऑफ समथिंग दैट यू लव बिकॉज दैट विल कीप यू गोइंग.
राइट,
अल्टीमेटली इफ यू वांट टू मेक अ शिफ्ट फ्रॉम योर पैशन टू प्रोफेशन, वो हो जाएगा. राइट, बट उस चीज के लिए आपको मेहनत करनी पड़ेगी. एंड वन लास्ट थिंग, विच इज व्हाट गुरुजी गैरी वी सेज, आई से दिस गुरुजी इन सम ऑफ माय ऑल ऑफ माय पोस्ट दैट आई मेंशन, वेयर ही सेज पेशेंस शुड नॉट बी misconstrued with lack of action. So just that piece of thought. बहुत लोग ये बोलते हैं कि patient रहो, सब कुछ ठीक होगा, सब कुछ ठीक होगा. But patient should not be confused with lack of action.
Yeah, for sure.
You need to keep executing and at the same time stay patient for the results.
Right.
ऐसा नहीं कि आप अरे यार ठीक है content नहीं बनाएंगे, जो होगा देखा जाएगा. Patient रहते हैं. That is something that should not happen. So patience should not be confused with lack of action would be my last statement.
Great, man. Again, truth bombs, interesting, and I'm sure a lot of people are going to take back a lot of things from here. On that note, once again, Deepak, thank you so much. This was awesome. And for all the listeners who listen to this, you know what to do. Like, share, subscribe. If you enjoyed this, tell us what you like. You want to get in touch with Deepak, you want to get in touch with us. You want a part two, you want more questions, hit us up, let us know. Thank you so much, listeners, once again. Thank you so much, Deepak. Hope you have a great day. Take care.
Thank you so much, Ishmeet, and to the entire team at Tag Mango. I'll personally call Divyanshu and Hasan for congratulating them on their success.
Absolutely.
But thank you so much, Ishmeet, for hosting me. You've been a lovely host. We'll surely catch up. Are you in the city? Right?
I am in the city for now, yes. We will.
Chalo, theek hai. Jab mauka milega, we'll definitely catch up. But thank you so much for having me, man. It's been an absolute pleasure. We'll definitely catch up. But all the very best for the entire team at Tag Mango. I think you all are doing some fantastic work. And for sure, let's rise together. Let's rise together, man.
100%. Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.
Thank you, man. Thank you. Cheers.